What are we going to create in this tutorial?
It can be a pipe, it can be straw, it can be umbrella handle, or it can be anything. So shift A, add a cylinder, and we will go with the 24 words. Then scale the cylinder along the Z axis like this.
Yes.
And then scale it down along the X and Y axis like this. So S, shift Z to scale it down along the X and Y axis.
And then what next?
We need to go to the edit mode and add a few loop cuts.
How many?
10 loop cuts. So add 10 loop cuts like this and add few more loop cuts here because we want to create that spring part or spring form, you can say. And so that's why you need to add 5 loop cuts in between these two loop cuts. Then you need to select these edge loops like this, shift alt click, and then select this edge loop. And what next? We need to add the bevel on them. So add a bevel, control B to add a bevel. And give the proper width and segment. By the way, we will go with the one segment, so don't worry about the segments. Then press I for the insert operation and scale it down along the X and Y axis. So S, shift Z to scale it down along the X and Y axis like this. And then you need to use the insert operation one more time. So use that insert operation. And next,
we need to add few loop cuts here. So add loop cuts from the top and loop cuts from the bottom like this.
So just add one loop cut. And then select these face loops with the shift select.
Shift alt click to select this face loop.
Okay, and then press I for the insert operation because
why?
We are going to use sub-D modeling. So that's why you need to add more loop cuts. Then select these faces and then delete them. We don't need those faces. And then add the sub-D modifier, share smooth it, increase the sub-D count up to 2 or 3, whichever you like. Okay, that's look pretty well. And what next?
We want to create bend add.
So basically we want to bend this form. So that's why we need to add empty.
But empty why? We need to add a bend modifier or deform modifier.
You need to add empty as well as a simple deform modifier and select that bend option and choose that empty in that simple deform modifier. And you can see we have bend that. You can say straw, pipe, anything. And you need to use these limits. So you can adjust the bending position or that bending
point
for that
point
with the help of these limits. So empty will help you to bend this model. And then you can adjust the angle like this. So just play with this simple deform modifier. Play with these limits to achieve the better results.
So simple thing.
So it's a very simple thing. You need to adjust the limits. You need to adjust the proper axis and then proper angle for bending. Okay, you can see in this way we can bend the form and we can use the vertex groups also. You can select the few words and you can use the vertex group. If you move your empty, then you can adjust the scale like this. So it's also help us to create the form. Okay, you can see.
Just move, you need to move it along the forward and backward direction along the X, Y axis. And then you can create a form with the help of empty.
Then you can create a form with the help of empty also. What next? Now we need to add more depth on it. So means thickness. So that's why select these edges top and bottom and E to extrude it and scale it down along the X and Y axis. So just scale it down like this. And then select this edge loop, right click and then
the edge loop.
Okay. And now next, we need to add few loop cuts at there. So add few loop cuts.
So add few loop cuts means how many?
Add 10 loop cuts like this.
10 loop cuts are enough?
No, we need to add more loop cuts at that spring part. We will add those loop cuts later on. Okay, now you can see that's look pretty well. But we are facing the little bit of difficulty with the bending because there are less loop cuts or particularly for that spring part from the inner side. So that's why we need to add the loop cuts from the inner side also on that spring part, so we will get smoother bend. Okay, so just add a loop cuts here and add loop cuts from the inner side also. But if we want to add the loop cuts at that particularly that springy part, or you can say anything to it, but for that part, then how we can do that? You can see if I use the deform modifier and apply that, then I will get the weird result because there are less loop cuts. So how we can add those loop cuts? we can't add the lookers from the outer side, so that's why we need to hide or we need to go inside of that cylinder. But it is quite difficult with the X-ray mode. So what can we do now? Okay, so just you need to use the X-ray mode and then select these faces. So just select these faces like this. And next, just go into that pipe or straw, anything. And then you need to add the loop cuts. How many? 5 loop cuts. So add those 5 loop cuts here, add those 5 loop cuts right there. And now that's look pretty well. Next thing, we need to add few loop cuts here because we have bent that pipe or straw. You can say anything. So that's why you need to add loop cuts like this. So we will get a decent bend at there. And we can make more good topology on the model. So that's why you need to add the loop cuts in this way. After getting the satisfied results, you can apply that bend modifier. And if you want to play more, then you can definitely. You can do a lot of tweaks in it and you can get amazing things. You can see. Okay, now we need to apply that modifier. So just apply that modifier and turn on that sub-D modifier. And you can see that's look pretty well. Now we don't need that empty, so you can delete it. And just move it along the Z-axis and take it a little bit up. And in this way, we have created that straw. You can work on it and you can create n number of objects, n number of forms from this particular model. What can we create with this?
We can create straw, we can create Christmas decoration things, and then we can create tap, we can create pipe, we can create anything.
Just you need to imagine and you can create anything.
Okay, we can create a lamp also.
That's another. And now you can see that's look pretty well. So thanks for watching. If you like this tutorial, then hit that like button and subscribe our YouTube channel. Bye bye. See you next video. Take care.